What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I'm FredEFuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, Multiplat Game Trap, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. This video has a lot of mistakes and edits beforehand. Now I got everything all situated out. I'm actually still doing a stream to Twitch and YouTube simultaneously via my PlayStation 4 and my Elgato capturing the PlayStation 4 going to YouTube and the other one streaming to Twitch. So I had to get a lot of bugs and errors and a lot of mistakes and little fixes and tweaks and all that shit, but it's all out the way. I still haven't perfected it. This is the first time I've seen anybody trying to do that, and it's the behind the scenes and you get to see the office, and I'm actually looking at myself on the screen, what is being streamed to YouTube and Twitch right now. Anyways, this video is dedicated to the fanboy, the fangirl, the corporate slave, the Xbox, the Sony pony, the Nintendrone, alright? The PC master race elitist. This video is for y'all motherfuckers. I'm tired of just fucking sitting by and watching and watch the community that I love and care about and the my favorite pastime in the world, which is fuck football, fuck basketball, fuck, you know, baseball, fuck rugby, fuck FIFA, I mean, not the game, but the actual, you know what I'm saying, football, real football. Fuck all that shit. My favorite pastime in the world is gaming. I used to do rapping and, you know, production of music and stuff like that, which I still do and stuff. But my favorite pastime in the world is fucking gaming. This is something that you can be a soldier on the battlefield. You can be a scientist in a game that has to do with quantum conundrum, where you're a scientist going through different multiverses and universes and shit like that, where you can be a fighter jet pilot or whatever the fuck you want to be and immerse yourself in gaming. But nowadays what it's filled with is a whole bunch of whining bitches or people that fucking are sucking on the dick of a corporation that makes something, or being, you know, bashing other people where they're fucking just a bunch of stupidity, like fucking, like we're in a fucking first grade in a sandbox and shit fighting over shit, you know what I'm saying? I mean, most of the people that do this type of stuff that I watch, grown men, you know, 18 and up. And the people that are 18 now, and I can understand y'all have that mentality. But the 18, you know what I'm saying, the adult gamers, the people that I represent, the people that I, you know, I try to talk to, my fans, my, you know what I'm saying, my community, this shit got to stop, man. I mean, really, this shit is fucking monotonous and stupid, and, you know, it's just, I guess, I mean, y'all want to fucking piss each other off and do shit for the giggles, but y'all are fucking calling each other out your names and wanting to fight each other and, you know, defending companies. Like, y'all got fucking stock in this shit or something. I mean, really, if y'all want to do this, tell me how much the how big your portfolio is with these companies. I mean, how much you have invested in them. I mean, other than what you have in your house. I mean, dividends, stocks, fucking bonds or something, belt, you know what I'm saying? What the fuck do you have invested in these motherfuckers? I mean, I know a couple of YouTubers that are actually invested into, and I don't know them personally, but I know that they are invested into companies. And I could see them, you know what I'm saying, pushing up that company to make more money. I could see that. I could see how that affects their bottom line or whatever. But, you know, whatever. Anybody else is just whatever. I seen two videos yesterday that made me understand that we have more in common than we have fucking that separates us. I seen MrTTech did a video response to, JackmoveJohnny. And JackmoveJohnny was talking about the pros and cons about the PS4. And it was basically stuff that he didn't even want to make the video. That's what he stated in the video. He didn't even really want to make the video. But he had to talk about it. You know, like the PlayStation 4, when you look at your friends list, sometimes it just doesn't load. Or on the Xbox side, when you go to invite somebody into a thing, if you want to back out, you have to back out or something. What he was talking about, MrTTech, and you might have your system crash on you or something like that. Then you have to do a hard reset. Then the friends list won't load, or this won't load, or something like that. So basically, if you look at the both, it's one coin, and it's just two sides of the same fucking coin. Now, then you have people on the Wii U. They can't do neither of that. They ain't got a fucking party chat or shit like that. So, and then they have, you know, the first party games are lacking in multiplayer or, you know, online, you know, functionality in general. Or just even Mario Kart 8 doesn't have any fucking chat at all. It's some pre-selected, pre-written stuff that you could say, hey, that was a good, fun race or whatever. So it's some fucking ass shit. I mean, really, are we fucking, instead of sitting here and voicing and telling and making these videos showing the problems with that we're having, like I'm gonna do a PlayStation 4 review and I'm gonna put all that shit in there and I'm gonna call it what it is, you know, say the truth. I'm gonna show the positives and the negatives, and I'm gonna actually have footage of both the positives and the negatives. Then it'll be an honest review. And I took so you gotta take a long time before you do a review on a product when it comes to any product, because you gotta run it through its paces, especially when it comes to electronics, when you have firmware and stuff like that. You can't just review it like 2 weeks, get a week or two. You gotta at least have it for a month or something, you know what I'm saying, to actually do a full-on review, or get it before it actually comes out, and then know that it, when you do put out your review, that it's going to have things that are going to be fixed on it and tweaked and worked on, and say that in the review. But shit, with all the fucking, man, fuck all you fanboys, fuck all you fangirls, fuck all you fucking super egotistical corporate dick riding asinine talking little fucking kids when you're over the age of 18 that have no fucking adult mentality, that don't fucking stand for shit. Fuck all y'all. Y'all all could eat a dick. Y'all all could unsub from me. You can leave me fucking bad comments and shit like that. I don't give a fuck about none of y'all. This channel here is for the adult, for the ones that stand for something, for the ones that have the goal, the fucking, the balls to speak their mind and let their opinions be known without sounding ignorant, one-sided, sounding like you're being controlled, or you're a robot speaking. You're a bot in a behind, you know, a little door, just typing what somebody else says. Where you don't have no fucking common sense or imagination, or even some authenticity, or even not even being able to. You ask a question on a comment or something, and you can't even Google what you're fucking doing. It just takes. You have the internet at your disposal, and you just look like an ass. Real talk. I mean, I don't like making videos like this. I mean, I don't like talking about people, but y'all motherfuckers is just out of control. It's rampant. It's the new disease of fucking YouTube or the internet. It's stupidity. I mean, y'all so worried about fucking putting up world star hip hop shit and making videos of people doing the stupidest shit, and I'm a minority. I'm Latino, so you know what I'm saying. When we do that, you're putting up shit like that, and then you wonder why a white dude in a tie is calling you some old derogatory shit. Well, you making yourself look like some fucking shit that they're saying, because you are fatting or making something trend that's negative about your own people. That's just stupid. And it's the same thing as gamers. We trend and make shit stupid and negative, and then you wonder why the media or fucking YouTube or anything just says something bad about us when we're not helping. What the fuck are we doing? What the fuck are we? We're not raising ourselves up to make ourselves a formidable force to be reckoned with, or positive, a positive enlightening front to fucking be talked about in a respectful manner. We're devastating ourselves. We're bringing ourselves down to such a level that even the corporations that y'all defend or bash are just like, whoa, what the fuck is going on? So that's what I'm talking about. I mean, really, are we a bunch of ignorant assholes? Are we, you know, the leaders of this generation that are, you know, we're in the, what, 8th, 9th generation of consoles? I've been gaming since the first generation of consoles. Atari, ColecoVision, the fucking, the Intellivision. Those were the first generation of consoles. Commodore 64, the Famicom, you know, the Atari 2600. I mean, come on, people. Let's do this. Let's huddle up. Let's stop fucking being ignorant. And if you're gonna talk shit and use factual intel to back you up instead of being all opinionated. I mean, you can have your opinion, but you can't post your shit and think opinion is fact. Opinion is your opinion. Opinion can never be fact. You know, it's just what it is. Stop fucking being some bitches, man. Real talk, man. I mean, it just, that's just this video. I just wanted to go in on you fanboys and fangirls and you X-Twats and Xbox and Sony ponies and fucking PlayStation fags. And there's so many fucking words for all that shit. But is it really, am I even helping by making this video? That's why I like making videos like this. But we have to understand that there's a coin and there's always two sides of a coin. And there's a story and there's always two sides of a story. And then there's fact and fiction and fact and opinions. And see where opinions lie in? Can be fiction. It can be based on fact as well. Opinion is right here, man. You know what I'm saying? Either you're going to be somebody of opinion that has a factual basis to your opinion, or how you based your opinion on facts, or is it going to be something on somebody else's opinion that's based on fiction, or is it going to be something swayed by the media and you're just going to be some dude making a video and ranting and raving and not even making no fucking correlation to anything. That's been my video. That's been it. I did this live stream. Y'all on the stream, I appreciate y'all coming by and just putting up with the mess and the debacle and the errors and the redoing and shit like that. I definitely appreciate it. I've been your host, your commentator, FredEFuego, Flame of Hot Entertainment, Multiplat Game Trap, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. Make sure to go check out my last four videos. Links will be in the description. If you like this video and you want to see more videos like this and show the background and all this other crazy stuff that I got going on right now, thumb it up. If you don't want to see shit like this, thumb it down. I'm going to leave a video, the links to both MrTTech's video talking about all the bad things that are and the problems that are on the Xbox, and then I'm gonna leave the video for JackmoveJohnny's all the things that are wrong with the PlayStation 4 right now. And they were both talking about JackmoveJohnny was talking about the Last of Us issues, and then MrTTech was talking about Titanfall's issues. So on this, their same videos or whatever. I did watch both of them. I thumbed them up. I didn't leave a comment on them because I wanted to actually be this video in the comment section, a link to this video, and actually showing y'all that you helped me with an idea on how to make this video, whatever. Just the core of this video came from that, watching those two videos. Was pretty entertaining, and it was factual. I like the fact that both there was showed both between both of those videos showed the, you know, the same side. But basically, y'all have more in common than you do. You know, there's more in common between gamers than there is anything that separates us. I've been your host, your commentator, FredEFuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, Multiplat Game Trap, the People's Voice, and your favorite average gamer. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.